Hello there, and welcome back to the Scott Rea Project and Boudin Noir Part 2. Like I promised in the first episode, I showed you how to mix it all, and this is the final mix. What we are going to do today is we are going to stuff it into skins and then cook them. Trust me, this is going to be stunning. Right, let me get those skins prepared. Okay, my favourite part, stuffing these, and we can cook them off. So I'm just going to give it one more stir, again, with my daughter, bless her frozen whisk. Daddy? Yes, princess? Why has my whisk got blood all over it? I don't know, babe, I haven't used it. Right, what we need then is natural hog skins. Out the wrapper. Swill them under cold water and then leave them in a bowl of water for about 30 minutes. Tie off one end, a decent knot. You do not want this leaking out of here. It'll look like an Ozzy Osbourne video. And then take your length of hog's casing. Don't tie a knot in it. Because that ain't cool. Come on. Right. What I'm using. The biggest tube from my sausage machine. The salami. And I fashioned a funnel. No expense spared. Product placement. Thank you very much. Ka-ching. I wish. And that is going to work like that. So. Basically a case of getting your skin over the end. Easier than it looks. There we go. Oh, reminds me of my youth. So basically, hold your skin on your nozzle and then fill up your jug and then just gently tip it in. Then you might have to coax it a little, but that's the beauty of having our apple and our fat diced small. It will go down. There you go, it's going. And the thing is not to stuff this too tight. Take your time with this and then just gently topping it up. Make sure to keep your hand on that skin. As you can see, snaking its way down to meet its friends. Very, very satisfying. Here we go again. Try not to do too big a length because you will get a burst and that ain't cool. Let's work its way down. It's going down. Very, very satisfying, as long as you don't get it tangled. And just keep doing more of the same. Just control the flow. Just watch it gently snake its way down. Make sure you've got your knot at the end. I cannot wait to try this. Obviously, I'm a big fan of the English black pud. Do it in about a foot and a half, 2 foot lengths. Or you can tie them off even smaller, as we would in the UK. That'll do for that one. How good do they look? Right, I am going to put some fresh ones in for you. I just want to show you these. These have been in for 30 minutes at a constant 160 Fahrenheit. Very, very light poach. And you must keep an eye on these. You do not want them bursting on you. Come on, you little beauty. Come on out. That's a monster. Straight into ice cold water. So here's my next batch then. As you can see, there's a little bit of room for movement. You don't want them overstuffed. Like I just said, 160 Fahrenheit constant. Check them after 20 minutes just with a pin. Prick them, and if blood comes out, they're not done. And then just check them periodically every 5 or 10 minutes. And as soon as you prick them and it will change to brown, it won't be blood comes out, they are done. Because believe it or not, you can overcook these beauties as well. But 20 minutes, my last batch took 30, 35, so just keep an eye on them. But you must keep your eye on that water. 160, what I do, if it's getting too hot, just add a little jug of cold water. Just stay over it. It's only 20, 30 minutes of your life. Think of the bigger picture. It's going to be superb. Right then, my friends, time for the big reveal. So we've been on a journey together. You see now we mixed the boudin, we stuffed it, and we cooked it. Remember what I say about that cooking? Don't go higher than 160 Fahrenheit, just a gentle poach. Don't stuff your casings too much. As soon as it's cooked, you can prick it with that pin like I said. And if blood comes out, give it a few more minutes, straight into ice cold water, then in the fridge to chill. And then, after a few hours or the next day, you get this. Stunning boudin noir. Just have a look at that. Absolutely amazing. It is a work of art. And it's only fair we cut in and have a look what all hard work was all about. Look at that, what a picture. So a bit of close-up action. Before we cut into this, remember I said we diced our fat small and we blanched it so it would stay pearly white when we cut into it, and this is the proof in the pudding. Just have a look at this. How good does that look? Absolutely stunning. And the taste? Oh. Très bon. This is charcuterie. This is nose to tail cookery. I mean, this from the noble beast that is the pig's blood. Just look at it. Absolutely amazing. Well, my friends, thank you for joining me on this epic culinary journey, this charcuterie masterclass, and what a fantastic end product. And if you've liked what you've seen here today, please, down here, click subscribe, and also on social media, on Facebook, Scott Rea, or The Scott Rea Project. And guys, get on there, friend me. We could talk one-to-one on Messenger. Also, on my Twitter, at The Scott Rea Project. And like it, share it, spread the word. Right, I am going to fry a bit of this up. It would be rude not to, but just have a look at that. It's a work of art. It's boudin, baby. Till next time, take care.